How's it going? Hold on. Let me adjust my yoga room. Still have my house slippers on. How embarrassing. How's it going? Good morning. Well, still morning here, technically, kind of. It's noon, lunchtime, Arizona. If you have some blocks, awesome. If not, no worries. I'll explain as we go. Get started in just a moment. One second. Right, I didn't grab a sip before we go. let me think. Excuse me. Sorry, I was teaching right before, and then I had to grab a quick snack in between because I was starving, I was famished. Had to eat something. Anyway, I feel much better now. I'm ready for yoga. Again, the vlog's just kind of optional if you have them. I will explain at times when they might be useful, helpful. And we will go from there. Same old Friday drill. Hope everyone's having a good Friday. It's a short week, although sometimes I feel like whenever it's like you got the Monday off, it feels like it's actually a longer week. Real mind game with that one. So anyway, hopefully it's been a short, wonderful week for all of you. So let's get started. Seated this morning. bringing yourself down onto your hips. Go ahead and cross your shins. Again, a block, great use to prop yourself up on, to be a little bit more upright. A blanket, a towel always works too. A chair, as I always say, use what you got around you, make it work. All right, yogis, I got my sweater on for now, but it'll be a moment once you start warming up. Go ahead and take your hands, go ahead and rest them on your thighs, sitting nice and comfy. Nice and tall, support through the core, softening of your shoulders, a nice broadening through your collarbones. And as you begin to find a nice length, just a nice grounding into your space, go ahead and soften your face and close your eyes. Just taking a moment. We're focused in on breath. I just did a nice sigh release. Because it's been a long morning, Eric. Not a bad morning, just, you know, a lot going on. So, acknowledge that. It's okay to acknowledge that maybe there's some tension, or maybe you're just, you know, things have been moving, going, and now you're taking a moment to slow down. And that audible sigh that I just did was a perfect example of just when you have that moment, you sit down, and you finally feel like you can have a sense of release. And that's what I want you to feel here. At any time, you take a breath, you take a child's pose, you pause, just meditate, focusing on your breath, first and foremost, on your mind, and just all of the power that we do carry that has nothing to do with moving our limbs around. Just all with our thought and our focus. So, that being said, shifting your thoughts and focus towards something positive in your life, something positive going on around you or with you. Maybe it's just a Friday that you just feel great and you're excited for the weekend. That's awesome. So whatever that is, building that up here, keeping that going, keeping that positive energy just rolling. Take a nice deep inhale. Out your mouth, let it go. And again, nice deep breath in. And release. One more deep breath in. Nice big inhale. And release. And taking a moment here, see if you can just gently press your lips together, allowing your breath to flow comfortably in and out of your nose. Creating ujjayi. And continuing here, allowing that breath to settle. And when you're ready, gently take your time, go and slowly lower your chin toward your chest, bowing your head. And when you're ready, go and gently begin to open your eyes. Bring your head back up to neutral. All right, Friday. Hello, how's it going? This morning, I keep saying this morning, sorry, it is morning in LA. Technically, it's 11 a.m. I know it's not morning in Arizona. Today, we're gonna go ahead and start right away by shifting those legs back, and let's go ahead and take it into a couple rounds of cat-cow. Go ahead and bring your wrist underneath your shoulders, knees underneath your hips, and go and give me a nice pull, that heart reaching forward, and as you exhale, chin to chest, belly to spine. And continuing to move, just finding that nice bit of mobility through your spine, releasing through your lower back. Couple more rounds here. And then again, feel free to take it into those side ribs, releasing through the neck. Now, I want you to go ahead and keep your hips stacked over your knees as they are. I want you to take a moment here. You're gonna walk your hands forward. So kind of like you're in a down dog on your knees. So your hips stay lifted and then you're gently pressing your heart down. Now again, depending on your mobility, that might not quite work where your chest doesn't go all the way down, that's fine. You're welcome to go to a chair and work this or even the wall and just gently reaching your heart down. And wherever that'll work for you, you'll feel it into the lats. I like to keep my face reaching forward, but if it feels good for you to bring your head down, go for it. Just a couple rounds here, just to stretch, just to open up. Over the chest, through the lats, taking one more breath here. And then taking your time. Whoo, go and slowly walk those hands back up. Awesome, now shifting forward again. Let's bring it into all fours. Now a little bit more heat through the core, softening through the shoulder. Begin to send your left leg back. Pause, keep that nice lift through the center. Hovering that left leg, pressing the left heel back. Begin to reach the right arm forward. Soften your shoulder away from your ear. Take a nice inhale, reach. Exhale, elbow to knee. And again, inhale, reach. Exhale in. Two more, reach. Exhale in. One more, reach. Exhale in. Now pausing here, finding that nice long reach and length shoulder. Drawing down onto your back, pausing here, taking one more breath in. And then gently releasing your hand, releasing your knee. Switching sides, begin to extend your right leg back. Nice support through your core, through your center. Reaching your left arm forward, pausing here. And then taking your time, hovering your right leg up. Take an inhale. Exhale, elbow to knee. Inhale, reach. And three more, exhale. And reach. Two more. And reach. One more. And reach. Pausing here, finding a little bit of length. A little bit more support through the center. And then gently releasing your hand. Releasing your knee. Now tuck all 10 toes. Let's go and hover those knees right off the mat. Pressing into your palms, softening through your shoulders. And as you exhale, just all that heat through the core. Really starting a lot here with just that center kind of warming us up. Getting it nice and heated through that core. Two more rounds of breath here. One more breath. And gently release your knees. Awesome. Take those hands, move them just about an inch or so forward. Spread your fingers, plant your palms, and then go ahead and take it all the way back up and into those legs, pedaling out 1 foot at a time. Now I'm getting warm. A gentle nod, yes. A gentle shake, no. A nice release. Through your neck, through your jaw, as you find some movement here. And just that nice little shift. Just pausing here for a moment. Nice spread of the hands. Nice reach. See if you can start to find stillness here just for a moment. Breathe into your down dog and feel the heart pressing down, those ribs drawing in and up, and then that reaching through the legs, nice grounding. Two more. One more round of breath here. And then as you inhale, go and come forward, come onto your toes. And I want you to take a nice deep bend in your knees. Press your hips back. Reach your heart down towards your thighs. As those inner thighs wrap back.
soften through your neck, through your jaw. And taking your time as you're ready, go ahead and bring yourself up. And walking your feet towards your hands, hands towards the feet, and pause here. Now letting the head release, falling forward. Go ahead and take a nice little clasp of hands to elbows, and feel free, just give me a little sway. I want you to open up along the hamstrings just a bit more. As you do that, soften your neck, soften your jaw. Nice little forward fold. And then from here, with a nice bend in your knees, take your hands and bring them to your lower back. Now pause, draw the shoulder blades together, hug the elbows in slightly. And then with a bend in your knees, I want you to lead with a long spine. Inhale brings you all the way up.
To stand. All right, happy Friday. I'm gonna bring the toes a little bit closer together. Big toes touch, shoulders nice and soft. And then as you inhale, go and float your arms up. As you exhale, reaching your heart forward, soft bend in your knees. Take it towards the mat.
Inhale, halfway lengthen.
Left leg steps back. Left knee all the way to your mat. As you inhale, float your arms up and overhead. And just open up those hips, especially that left hip flexor. Pressing it down, lifting the hip bones up. Shoulders nice and soft. Taking two more here. One more breath. And then as you exhale, go ahead and gently release. Now I want you to tuck your back toes. Lift the back knee, pause. Now back leg is lifted. Go ahead and bring, and if you ever need, again, here's where a block would be good. If you can't quite reach, you can bring a block under the hand. Take your right arm and just airplane that right arm right alongside your hip. Reaching that heart forward, pausing here just for a breath, just the one side. Feel that right shoulder blade drawing down onto the back, and then feel that nice pull of the heart forward. Taking one more round of breath here. As you exhale, gently release your right hand down, take your gaze forward, bend your back knee, step to the top. Switching sides, right foot steps back, right knee drops down to the mat. And as you inhale, float your arms up and overhead. Pausing here, nice lift through your belly, tailbone drawing down, shoulders soft, triceps wrapped. Taking two more here. Just to take a moment, just open up our hips. Again, it's just a stretch, let the hips know. All right, hips, I want you to open up a bit more from all that time you might spend seated in your chair at a desk. Gently release, tuck your back toes, lift the back knee now, fire through the legs. Again, if you took the block on one side, if you got one block, awesome, move it over. If you got two, great. If you don't have a block, no worries. Again, if you're not using a block, you can cup the hand. And then it's that left arm just reaching back here. I'm using the block. Like guys, I did 3 HIIT classes before this, and my body's like, I need a little support. And that's a perfect example of a day where you're just like, you need to listen to your body. Some days, your body's going to be able to push more than others. It's all right. If not every day is a all out, go, 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 go day. You take the day as you need it. Taking one more breath. And gently release. Go ahead and plant your palms. Step it back. Shoulders over wrists. Pause. Broaden through your collarbones. Take an inhale. Exhale, lower all the way out to your belly. Ooh. All right, so I want you to charge up that upper back a bit more here. We're gonna start with the arms forward. So I want you to turn the palms in towards each other. Hopefully you can see. Ooh. Back a bit. So palms are gonna face in. From here, you're gonna do opposite arm as leg. So as you lift, bring your right arm and left leg. Now, if you're feeling a lot of pulling in that lower back, lower it slightly, and that's fine. But you wanna think of drawing your lower belly in, lifting your hip bones. And don't think so much height, I want you to think reach. Like you're trying to reach forward and you're trying to reach back with those toes, taking one more breath here. And gently lower, you're gonna switch sides. Left arm floats up, right leg floats. Now I am pushing down with my right hand, that right pinky, into the mat as those shoulders soften away from the ears. Keep that nice length and reach here. Two more. One more round of breath. And lower. Now let's work it on the breath here. Right arm, left leg, inhale it. Exhale, lower. And again, inhale, left arm, right leg. And lower. Let's go two more each side. Right arm. And lower. And left arm. And lower. One more each side. Right arm. And lower. And last time, left arm. And lower, pause here. Take those hands, slide them next to your ribs, shoulders soft away from your ears. Now pressing down into that mat. We've already started to get some nice work into that upper back. Shoulders soft, tuck your toes, hips up and back, downward facing dog. And take your pedal as needed, reset. Gonna tighten up the lower back a little bit, wiggle it out. Shoulders soft from the ears. Soften through your neck, through your jaw. And then when you're ready, coming onto your toes, look forward. Bend your knees. Exhale, if you wanna take a little hop this time or a little skip, bring it up, big toes together. Inhale, press halfway. Exhale, fold. Arms overhead stand. And hands to heart. Taking it back down, inhale, float. Exhale, dive. Inhale, halfway. Take your left foot, step it back. Pausing here. Now, reaching your heart forward, shoulders soft. Now, we did one arm last time. If that's enough, stick with one arm. If you wanna go with both, whoo, all this lift through the core. Again, firing up that core right away this morning, shoulders soft this Friday. Two more breaths. One more round. And then inhale, bring your arms up. Take that sweep, pause, that lift through the core. Hugging right outer hip back, nice deep bend through the front leg. Take one more inhale. Exhale, gently release. All right, Alex. A nice hamstring stretch. Hop that back foot up about halfway. Folding over that front leg. Again, adjust as needed. You can use blocks to help support you, a chair. A soft bend through that front knee also works. Just taking a fold. One more round of breath here. Bend your front knee, and then go and step it to the top, and switch sides, right foot steps back. Now charge up that back leg, hug the left hip back. Reach your heart forward, soften your shoulders, and then work it through your core. That's what's lifting, as those shoulders soften. Good. Now maybe it's just one arm. Maybe you're still just working with that left arm back, perfect. From that center, broadening along the collarbones, taking one more inhale. And exhale. Inhale, reach up. Nice big reach, wrapping triceps forward, sending those hips down. Woo! Getting that nice big lift, hugging that left outer hip back. Two more rounds of breath. One more round. And exhale, good, release. Now take your back foot, hop it up about halfway. Take a nice little fold, hugging that left outer hip back. Take a moment, just release over this left leg. Gentle nod, gentle shake. And then from there, plant your palms, step it back. Now, as you set up for your vinyasa, if you're ready for an up dog, lower halfway, pause, flip your toes, bring it up. Find that nice lift. Exhale, lower, take it back. Draw your shoulder blades up away from your ears, soften through your jaw, through your neck. Take a deep breath in. Out your mouth, let it go. Now we're gonna try, again, a little spring hop forward. Coming up high onto your toes, bend your knees. And at the end of your exhale, little hop, little skip, little air time, bringing those big toes together. Inhale, halfway. Exhale, fold. Arms overhead, stand tall. Exhale, hands to heart. All right, a nice neutral balance here, hands to hips. Bring your left knee up. Now press that right big toe down into the mat. Pausing here. If you want to hold it, you can hold it. Don't pull the heart forward though. Keep that nice lift through the chest. Might even pull it up, get a little stretch into that left glute. One more round of breath here. And then go ahead and step your left foot all the way back. Right into your crescent pose. Pause. Now we're gonna repeat it, but we're going in reverse this time. So feeling this nice center engage. Release down, broadening through the collarbones. Now power, I want you to feel power through the back leg. Remember, the back legs are important. Make them work. Because they will be just dead weight hanging out. We want them to be working and pushing with us. Taking one more breath. And gently release your left hand. Take your right arm, reach it up to the sky. Taking your twist. Again, power through that back leg. I keep saying it, inner thigh reaching up, but it's important, that's why. All right, we're going all the way over, Vasisthasana. Drop your left heel, you can stack the heels, stack the feet, Strong through your obliques, a nice wide reach. Soften through your neck, through your jaw. One more round of breath here. If you want, you can extend your arm all the way up and over your head. And then as you exhale, take your time, bring it forward. Now vinyasa or down dog, you decide. You can keep heating up the practice.
Shifting it back as it works for you. Nice little pedal, nice little adjustment. Deep breath in.
Let it go.
Coming high up on your toes, look forward.
Bend your knees. Step or hop, bring it to the top of your mat.
Inhale, halfway. Exhale, fold. Arms overhead. Exhale, hands to heart.
Switching sides, plant your left foot down. Bringing your right knee up. And feel free, I encourage. I said just to hold it last time, but you know, or just to hold the leg without the hands, but feel free, take a little wrap here. And not soft with the standing leg, really engage and lift, keeping the heart lifted. Collarbones nice and broad. Taking one more breath here. Now with control, bending your left knee, pause. Step it all the way back, take your lunge, float your arms up. Again, all the center engaged, use it. So gently release the arms, collarbones broad, shift it forward. Pausing here. Shoulders away from ears. Length through your spine, hugging your left outer hip back. Two more. One more. And as you release, bringing your right hand down, go ahead and flip your left arm up. Now taking your twist, stacking your shoulders. Don't lock out the elbow, soft bend. And then from here, if it feels right for you, dropping that back heel. Again, you can always modify by bringing the knee down to the mat or stepping a foot forward. Lift it through the side waist, broadening through the collarbones, softening through your neck, through your jaw. One more inhale. Exhale either into your vinyasa or straight back to your downward facing dog.
Taking a nice deep breath in here.
Out your mouth, let it go.
Gentle nod, gentle shake. And then from here, coming high up on your toes, look forward. Exhale, bend.
Step or hop, bring it all the way up.
Inhale, halfway lengthen.
Exhale, fold.
Arms overhead, stand.
Ooh, hands to heart. All right, yogis, awesome. Now I want you to go ahead and turn and face the left side of your mat. So we're gonna do this from standing. We're not gonna get into it from the Surya. Sorry, my mind was like escaping for a moment, trying to think of too many things at one time. So go ahead and turn towards the left side of your mat and then step your feet nice and wide. And a really good judge, especially when you are turned side and you set up in a warrior pose, warrior two, which is what we're doing like this. Best judge is to make sure that ankles are underneath your wrists. So that's about how wide you want your warrior two legs to be. Wider than we think. We always go shallower. Go wider. Now turn left toes up, right toes all the way forward, and then go ahead and take that nice deep bend. Press it down. Keep that nice lift through your belly. Now we're going to flow slightly here, but I want you to keep this nice length into your ribs. Take an inhale. As you exhale, take forearm to thigh. Pause. Don't sink. Lift up. You know the drill. Lift it through those ribs. Now keeping that core engaged as you inhale, bring it back up. Flipping your palm, take it back. Inhale up and take it forward. Feel free to start sweeping that arm all the way overhead. Inhale up and back. One more round here, inhale up. Forward and last time here, inhale up. Pause in your reverse warrior. Now can you deepen that bend in your front knee a little bit more rather than straightening, go a little bit deeper. Yes, one more breath. Bring yourself all the way back up. And then lengthen. Whoo! Now turn your toes angled. Goddess pose. Toes slightly rotated out. Send those hips down, hands to heart. Squeezing through the glutes, hugging. Hips back, wrapping those thighs down. Nice lift and length. Taking two more rounds of breath here. One more round. And then as you exhale, go ahead and shift those hips down. And then extend your front leg towards straight. Keep that inner thigh reaching up. Send it down. Skandhasana. So really deep into this inner thigh here. Lift it as much as you need. Again, if available, you're taking it down. But you want to flex. Do not let the toes fall forward. Keep those toes and inner thigh reaching up. Maybe hands to heart. Two more rounds of breath. Now press. I'm lifting through my core. I'm reaching through my leg. One more round here. And then I want you to bring your hands down. Shift forward. Woo. Now both heels down. Rotate all the way to the top of your mat. Pause. Now square off your pelvis. As you exhale, float your left foot. Let your head drop down. Now don't let that left hip sink. Keep it nice and even with the right hip. Pressing out that left heel. Shoulder blades lifted. One more round of breath here. And exhale, bring your toes together. Inhale, halfway. Exhale, fold. Arms overhead, stand. And hands to heart. Awesome. Now, take it to the other side. Open to the right. Step those feet out. And again, aligning. Ankles under wrist. Once you're there, go ahead and bend your left knee. Left toes forward, right toes up. And then just take a nice deep bend. Hugging that left hip back. Lifting the belly up. Pelvic floor as that tailbone reaches down. And then pressing your palms down. Square off the shoulders. Nice and strong. Pressing palms down. Take an inhale. And then from here, bring your forearm down. Bring your arm up and over. Soften your shoulder. And then as you inhale, you're bringing it back up. Flipping that front palm. Take it back. And again, bring you up. And over. Bringing it up. And back. One more round here. And forward. And last time, bring it up. And back. Pause. Now see if you can sink just a little bit deeper. Stretching through the side waist. One more round of breath here. And bring it up with control. Woo! And extend. All right. Turning your toes towards the side. Hands to heart to start. Draw the heels in. As you exhale, send your hips down. Pause. Nice length through your side waist. Now maybe this time, you take those arms up and overhead just for a little bit more intensity. Why not? If it's too much, hands down. Pausing here. Send those hips down. Take two more. One more inhale. Exhale. Now, shifting your weight over to your right leg. Pressing through your left heel. Send your hips down. And then gently drop. Taking your time. Skandhasana. Inner thigh up. Really reaching through those inner thighs. Nice big hold here. As you get a nice flex into your left leg. Two more rounds of breath. Hands are down. If needed, feel free to support. One more breath. And then shifting it back to center. Ooh. Rotate your right toes up, taking your gaze forward. And then as you exhale, float your right leg up off the mat, standing split. Don't worry about the height. Square off your pelvis. Let your head drop. Hands go what works best for you. Taking one more round of breath here. And then as you exhale, go ahead and gently release your feet down, pausing. Inhale, lift to lengthen. Exhale, fold. Arms overhead, stand. And hands to heart. Awesome, yogis. All right, take a moment, ground into your hands, out of heart. Take a nice deep breath in. Let it go. Releasing your arms. Inhale, float. Exhale, dive. Inhale, halfway. Your choice, vinyasa, or meet me right back down in your downward facing dog. Inhale, lift. And exhale, hips up and back. Pause here for a moment. Give it a little pedal.
a little reach. All right, right knee is coming to your left shoulder. Now we're gonna take it open here, a little rotation. So I want you to inhale, float the right leg. As you exhale, bring that knee across and then pause. I want you to extend the leg out. Now, pinky toe of my right foot is down, and then I'm gonna drop my left heel all the way to the mat too. So that back heel, can you see, is dropped all the way to the mat. Now keeping my hips lifted, maybe the hands, maybe both arms reach up. Nice reach here. Working strong through the obliques, pressing down that right hand. Two more rounds of breath. One more. And as you exhale, gently release your hand, bring your knee to your nose. Step your foot between your hands. Now, we're gonna go right into our warrior two. If you happen to have prompts with you, have them nearby towards the top of your mat. Drop your back heel and go and sweep it on up. Woo! Pressing down. Now we're going for our big balance. Belly's lifted. Pressing into that back foot. Softening through our shoulders as we extend. Exhale, I want you to reach forward. Now if you have a block, feel free to use it. Otherwise, hand is coming to the outside of your foot. Left hand to hip. Shift your gaze forward. And begin to bring your left foot up. Stand, or half moon pose. Now remember the difference between standing split and half moon, because I almost said standing splits right there and I meant half moon. Standing splits in Warrior 3, we have the pelvis squared. This one, we have the pelvis stacked. So, left hip over right, maybe the arm comes up. Now just feeling the difference of that. So feeling this openness here, but still supported, still lifted, taking one more breath. And exhale, gently bring it down and pause. Now, I want you to really get a sense of both of those. Why? Because we're going to go into what we haven't done in a while, which is practice our kick up. So that difference of feeling your hip open versus feeling your hip neutral. So right now I want you to come back to that neutral hip. So even if you need to take a moment just to feel that. So there's our neutral. All right, that was our open hip, but I want neutral hip. Why? Because we're going to play with that kick. So take a moment, reset yourself, plant your palms, taking your left leg up. Now bend your right knee. Pause, shoulders over wrist, heart is reaching forward, then you take that nice kick switch. Now remember, back leg is important. Reach out the back leg. Again, we don't want it to get too frantic and start to flail around. So, using that core, I'm going to give it a couple kick switches. Woo! And I know it's been a moment since we've done this, so there's no pressure, no stress. Get those legs high, go where it works for you. But shoulders stay over wrists. Taking one more round here on your own. And when you're ready, we'll meet back. And a nice forward fold. Go ahead and take those feet a little bit wider than hips width. And from here, clasp hands to elbows. A little sway, a little hang. And then releasing. Bring your hands either onto shins or mat. Inhale halfway. Plant your palms, either vinyasa or meet me back in a downward facing dog. Nice pedal, nice release. Take a deep breath in. Out your mouth. Inhale left leg. Exhale, bring your knee across to your right shoulder and extend your leg out to the side. Now, pinky toe side is down. Drop your right heel. Keeping those hips lifted, nice and stacked. Broaden here. Reaching towards the ceiling, reaching towards the sky. Turning on those obliques, why not? One more inhale. And then bring your hand down, bring your knee to your nose. Step your foot all the way between your hands. Now again, feel free to have your block or any prop nearby. Drop your right heel down. As you inhale, inhale that arm up. I always reach for my thigh. I don't know why it's happened. I noticed that when I watch. I never watch myself do yoga. This is the only time I do it on camera. It's comical. Lifting the belly up, my little habits. Taking one more breath here. And then go ahead and gently release. Hand to block, hand to mat. Now take your right hand to your hip. Shifting forward, now keep that left hand to the outside of that left pinky toe, and then reach. Send your heart forward, and then
You don't have to perfectly stack your hips. That right hip is still slightly forward, but that goal is that opening there. Maybe that right arm, again, just getting that difference of one side to the other. Two more here. Strong through your center. One more breath. And then taking your time, gently bend your left knee. Release your right foot. Woo! Take a fold. Now we know we're still gonna go into that inversion practice again. If once was enough for you, if you don't like that going up and down type of feeling, if you need to take a moment, a break, do it. Otherwise, if you want one more round, you're gonna go ahead and switch. Hovering the right foot up, pause, just get that feeling of square. Now remember, shoulders over wrist, collarbones broad, keep your gaze forward, bend, and then think core, lift, and switch. And core, strong legs, and switch. Also, really pushing into the fingertips, because again, I know there's that fear, I'm gonna fall forward. Push down into those fingertips to stop you, but keeping that core connected so that the fingertips are literally the ones that if that core is turned on, it will push you back from falling over. Go ahead and take a couple rounds on your own. After you've done a few, no rush. Bring them to the top, taking your feet hips width. I want you to turn your palms up. Step right underneath the balls of the feet and just take a moment. Whew. Hang. Bend your knees as much as you need here. One more round of breath. And then go ahead and take the hands out from underneath. Inhale into halfway. Exhale, fold. Arms over headstand. Then hands to heart. I wanted to bring us from that upright because we've been head under hips for a minute. So we're going into another balance here. It's our crow pose. Again, if you're like done with the balances, cool, I get it. It's also just great to work on your yogi squat. So taking those toes out a little wider, sitting those hips down because it's all this mobility. And it's funny, as I've been teaching HIIT classes down too, I have one of the other trainers, I love it because she'll do like our warm up all when I take other classes. And she'll have people go into yogi squat like this because there's so much warm up, especially anyone who's working into like squats, lunges, and you're doing really weighted stuff. One huge thing is just your actual mobility of your ankle, knee, hips. In order to get to a full range of motion, you need to have that nice mixture of flexibility and strength. So, she always does this in her warm-up, and I love it because it's really hard for people to do. So, maybe this is a challenge for you, just working on getting those heels down, opening up through the hips, again through the ankles, through the knees, adjust as needed. If you want to go for the balance, shift your hands forward, hugging your elbows in. Hips nice and high, coming onto those toes. Shift it forward, one foot, maybe the other. Broadening. And then as you exhale, you can step it back. You can hop it back into vinyasa. Straight back to down dog. Take a nice deep inhale. Out your mouth, let it go. And let's bring your knees down to the mat. Let's go ahead and have you move into a child's pose. Yes, a little break. I want you to take a break because we're going to get into some Pinchamayurasana in just a moment, or dolphin pose in just a moment. Sorry, Pincha is the full inversion. All right, shifting it forward. Now, for any of my friends who happen to have a block with them, awesome. It's not necessary. It's kind of a good gauge, though, to place the block in front, and then I'm making, like, the letter L with both hands, and I'm placing it just around the block, because you don't want to bring your hands in too close. So from there, drawing those elbows underneath my shoulders, broadening my collarbones, pulling the heart forward, kind of like what we did earlier. Now remember, your head does not touch the mat here. Your head will stay lifted. You'll see my hair hitting the ground because my hair is big and crazy, but my head is actually not resting. From there, lift your hips and walk your toes in. Now keep pushing down. Again, there's no connection of my head to floor. My head is lifted. And then pushing your heart back. Now breathe into it. Two more rounds of breath here.
One more. And as you exhale, go ahead and gently release, bringing the hips down. Ooh. All right. Yogis, how'd that go? Hopefully it went well. It's really, really challenging. It's not an easy pose. In fact, I actually think doing the full inversion, actually kicking upside down, is easier because of how we're angled with our shoulders. Because there's a lot of strength, but then again, kind of tied into what I was talking about, yogi squat. There's that mixture of strength and flexibility. You need that range of motion, but then you have to have the support to hold it there and maintain. So if one was enough, perfect. If you wanted just a little bit more heat, but maybe not quite that much, you're welcome to shift into just a plank pose here and hold it, which is gonna be great for your core. Otherwise, if you want one more and you wanna add, you can lift one leg at a time and I'll go in that with you. So elbows down, right under your shoulders, broaden through your collarbones, and then take your time, lift your hips, walking your legs forward. Now, you can bring those toes all the way together if that feels best, and you can float one leg. Just seeing how that feels again. Pelvis is square, the difference between opening and square, switching sides. Now, the reason why it's important that we look forward is because eventually, if you ever, ooh, that was a bad demo. If you ever wanted to kick up, you could go into the full inversion. So that's why we play with that practice, showing just for fun, dropping the knees down. You don't need to do it right now. I would recommend not doing it if you've never done it before and you're at home and alone. Don't do it now. But just so you know, that's where it could end up going, and it's lots of fun. Take a moment. Take a nice deep breath in here. Out your mouth, let it go. All right, just a little bit more opening through the chest, the front of the body. Go ahead and bring yourself onto your hips, and go and bring those legs out in front of you. Bring your hands back behind you. Planting those palms down. Now, fingers, make sure they're not facing the other direction, opposite of you. Make sure they're facing towards your hips. As you plant your feet, as you broaden through your collarbones, take an inhale. And as you exhale, I want you to lift your hips, pulling your tailbone forward. Keep the broadening. Take an inhale. If it feels right through your neck and you gently want to release the head back, go for it. Two more. One more round of breath here. And exhale, whoo, gently release. Nice, now keeping those collarbones nice and broad and lifted. Our last bit of heat before we start to cool things down a bit. If one was enough, no worries. If you want one more, plant down, lift up, engage. And then just very gently, as you let the head drop back. One more here. Exhale, whoo. Awesome, yogis. All right. Shifting those legs back and around. We're going to go into our pigeon. We're already going to open up those hips here from a down dog. And I'll explain why it'll make sense because we're going to give the option to flip that pigeon. Flip that dog. Let's go and shift it up. Bringing right knee forward. Just hugging right outer hip back. Taking a moment. Now, no pain. A block. Perfect idea for any tight hips. Mine are actually feeling a little tight right now too. A little help. Elevation helps. It's all ego. It is. Even myself, like I'll be like, no, I can force my hips down. No need to force it. Your body, as you breathe, will start to slowly release. And each day is different. So if you're a little tighter, use some support and feel free to drop your torso down. Slowing your breath down. Couple more rounds here. And then taking your time, going slowly, walk your hands back up. Now, if you don't want to flip the dog, that's fine. You can just take it straight back to down dog. You can take the right leg up in the air to swing it. If you want to keep rotating over, go for it with a nice lift through the hips. And a nice reach up and back. Two more here. Right leg is bent, left leg is straight. Taking one more breath.
opening the heart, and then bring it back around.
And we're gonna go ahead and switch sides. Bring the left knee forward.
And hugging the left outer hip back. And adjust as you need. No pain in the knee. I will say it actually felt good when I elevated my hip slightly on the other side because of my knee. Like I said, I'm sure I've talked about this before. I get very sensitive about my knees. I just want to keep them safe for like forever. Forever. I want to be doing yoga until my last breath. Yoga and movement. So that's why it's important. Just, you know, yeah, we always, it's good to push, but it's also good to be safe and just know where your limitations are sometimes. Having a healthy body first and foremost. And you go from there. Not a competition. It's not a race. It's your own personal growth and experience, so take that as you can. Slowing your breath down. Bring yourself back up, walking your hands up, tucking your back toes, and from here, go ahead and send your left leg up. Again, maybe you just open up that hip, maybe give it a couple circles, maybe you send the foot all the way down, nice lift and reach. Two more here. One more breath. And gently release. And go ahead and bring your knees down. And bring your legs around. All right, yogis, nice work. So, I'm gonna give us, well, okay, let me not get too ahead of myself. Let's go ahead and start with the nice straight leg. So go ahead and lift the skin of your bum. Reaching your arms up and overhead. And as you exhale, go ahead and take a dive. I was gonna start explaining our pose that's coming up later, but as too early. I'll get there in a moment. Reaching that heart forward, soften your shoulders. When there's no one else around me, sometimes I talk out loud, but like what should just be said in my head. Obviously, when I have people in front of me, I am better at just being like, nope, that's for your head. Anyways, I know. One more breath here. And go and take a nice little lift. Go ahead and bend your knees. Send them out to the side. And soles of your feet together. Hands on feet if that works best for you. Hands out in front if that works better for you. Just a nice little fold. One more breath. And taking your time, walking your hands up. Now, here's where I'm going with this. We'll start with bridge, and I'll talk to you into the rest. I wanna kinda talk us into a shoulder stand today. The thing about shoulder stands is that because of the way and how we're kinda positioned, I just want you to be very, very careful. I want you to feel like you're getting into it safely because it's the neck that we are most, you know, wanna keep safe. Your cervical spine is very delicate, so I'm going to talk you through it slowly. Feel free to opt out. Feel free to just meditate here. You can even settle into a shavasana if you like. Breathe. But that being said, we're going to just start with a bridge pose, and we'll work our way up from there. So decide to move into what feels most comfortable for you. All 10 toes forward, brushing your heels with your fingertips. And as you exhale, go ahead and lift your hips up. Now pause, sending your tailbone forward, lifting your hip bones up. Interlace. Fingers behind your back, and see if you can gently draw the shoulder blades slightly more together and down. You'll get a nice lift here. Soften your shoulders down. Now the back of your head is what's on the mat, not your neck. So even here, notice it's the back of your head and your shoulders. Taking one more round of breath. And exhale, go ahead and gently release. Lowering down, pausing here. Now, from here, you can either do another bridge, stay with that, you can work your way into wheel. Otherwise, I'm gonna give the option to head into shoulder stand. Now, I'm gonna demo first. If you've never done it, I want you to watch carefully. I will talk you through it. Why I'm gonna demo first, I don't want you looking at the camera while you're doing it. Your gaze should be straight up the whole time. So if you get confused and you wanna look, come down, come out of it, and then look at what's going on. And then once you've got it, head back up and then go into it. You don't want your neck moving around when we have the weight over our head. So how it would start is that you're going to press into the ground and you're gonna bring your hips up and over. Now, for some of us that might not work, there is a table behind me. Sometimes just even bringing your feet onto a chair or a table behind you, that might be where you go. And this is awesome, just getting into this position here. Now, notice I brought my hips up and over. Again, my gaze is up towards the ceiling. Once you get here, you're going to interlace your fingers, draw your shoulder blades together. Your neck should not be touching the mat. Remember, it is a shoulder stand, not a neck stand. Shoulder blades draw together. Your gaze is reaching up. This, again, might be enough. Take it step by step, how it works for you. Ultimately, we're going for here, but if not, no worries. So, breakout. Again, I'm going to talk you through it slowly. If you were watching, hopefully you weren't, and you weren't looking at me and trying to do it. From here, take your time, go ahead and press, and shift your hips up and over. And if you're already feeling like, whoa, this is a lot, perfect. Stay here, this is a lot. And it actually feels great. It feels great for my back. Whew. Now, if you want to go with that next step, draw the shoulder blades in, hands towards the back. Take your time. One leg, the other leg. Now again, it's on your shoulders and the back of your head, not your neck. Your neck should not be flat on the mat. And even if it's just too much with both legs, do one leg, or just that bend, that tug, bring you in. We're trying to get those hands as high up onto the shoulders as possible. And you can even hear, my voice is a little labored here, because in the position, it's a lot of push onto your lungs, onto your throat. One more round, and take your time, go and gently release. Woo! Again, don't look around. If you need to come out of it, you go out, straight out of it. Otherwise, take your time. I love a gentle roll out of my shoulder stand. That's like my favorite part, is the exit. Feels so good on my back. All right, if you did it, awesome. If you didn't, do not worry. It is a very challenging pose. It's very common though in yoga, but it's harder to do when you don't have someone literally telling you what's right and what's wrong in person, because I can't see bodies. Take your hands, palms down underneath your sacrum, your upper bum, lower back, and then from here, I want you to straighten your legs out, bring it onto your elbows, on your forearms, and then I want you to lift. And then take your time again, slowly reach the crown of your head back, pausing here. Just a nice release, opening through your throat. Taking one more round of breath here. And as you exhale, draw your chin in, take your elbows out, and gently lower. And release. Good. Go ahead and extend your legs out. Now we have just completed in a neutral. If you feel that your body needs another twist, you can go for it. We didn't twist a lot today. But if you're feeling nice, even, and settled after all that work, extend your legs, extend your arms. Allow your head to drop down. Take a nice, comfortable inhale. Comfortable exhale. And begin to move into your Shavasana. As your body settles, closing your eyes, soften your face, soften along your jaw. And just find stillness. Gently begin to deepen your breath, bringing movement back to your fingers and your toes.
bringing your arms over your head. Take a nice
stretch and reach through your body. And as you're ready, rolling to your side, bend your knees. Pause here for a moment.
And your next exhale, take your time, pressing yourself up. Crossing at your shins. As you sit tall, feel free to bring your hands together at heart center. Take a deep breath in. And release. Two more deep breaths in. And release. One more nice big breath in. And release. Sealing in all your practice, all your work, all your effort. Namaste. Thank you so much, yogis. Happy, happy Friday. I hope you enjoy the rest of your day. Drink lots of water. Enjoy your weekend. And yeah, I'm doing it all again next Friday. But yeah, have a good one. Thank you, Hector. Oh no, you're good. No worries. I was like, I think he's here. But I'm glad you made it. Awesome. I know with the time change and everything, but right, I mean, by time change, I mean, we moved the class time, and LA and Tucson are on different times, but that's what I mean. But anyway, awesome. Thank you so much. And I will be back again next Friday. So have a great weekend, and hopefully I'll be around then. Love lunchtime. Awesome. Me too. It works. It's a good time. It's good. I like it. I'm not rushed and frantic coming into it now like I used to be before. I felt horrible. Like, oh my gosh, I've got to start. I'm late. I'm stuck on the 405. Now I'm just like, ah, I can take my time getting home. I don't have to like drive like a maniac. But awesome. All right. Well, enjoy. Have a good one.